Hey friend, it's Brian here. I'm so happy to see you guys. I'm hanging out with you guys, but this is definitely going to be my last video. I'll tell you why in just a second. But hey to my besties, hey to, last video for the day. Not last video ever. Last video for the day. Hey to my besties, hey to my new friends that are coming on in, and hey to my old friends that are coming on back. Thank you guys for being here. So look, this is what's going on. I can hear out of this ear right now, but I can't really hear out of this ear. I went to the doctor, they weren't able to fix it, but it is not anything that's going to be permanent, I don't think. I'm taking some medicine, I gotta see a specialist. But it's just really made for a very awkward few days, okay? Because no one's known that I can't hear in this ear, because I can still hear. But it's amazing how having like 50 and 60% hearing changes so much in your day and changes so much about how you go about life. And I've just been here. This ear is working overtime, and if I'm talking, like my voice is echoing in my head right now. So sometimes people actually can't hear me if I'm talking, because apparently I think I'm talking loud and I'm talking very soft. And or sometimes I feel like I'm yelling. I feel like I'm yelling right now. So I've done a few videos today. I really honestly can't do anymore. I just feel so tired. But we're going to do one more because you guys have wanted to for us to watch Dara Ong, and I want to watch it too. So I'm going to push through to this one. And look, if you are new here, or you need a reminder, this is how it works. Me and my friends get together on YouTube, watch some of the coolest videos that I would know nothing about. And it's like good friends on my left to tell me about it. That's where you guys come in, good friend. You let me know what videos or musical artists, what musical videos and what live performances we need to watch. And look, we watch them as soon as we can. Life gets in the way, but we keep on trucking, and we choose music because music is such a great way to connect to people. I can connect where you are, you get to come where I am, we all go where the artist is, and there's a lot of places to go. I call that a musical vacation. And if you need your ticket, your passport, you need your visa, look, I don't know nothing about it. You can come over here, we can hang out, okay? Hit the subscribe button, and that's your ticket to get in. And that's also, that lets me know how we're friends. So be my friend and hit the subscribe button, okay? All right, let's check out Dara Ong. And Dara Ong has some friends with him. Who he has? Oh, we'll find out at the end. It's starting. Y'all already know I can't tell Dara from nobody. I think that's Dara. That's Dara.
Once I was 7 years old, my mama told me, go make yourself some friends or you'll be lonely. Once I was 7 years old.
He has a different tone. Very different.
It was a big, big world, but we thought we were bigger. Pushing each other to the limits when we learning quicker. By 11 spoon, drinking burning liquor. Never rich, so we were out to make that steady figure. Once I was 11 years old, my daddy told me, go get yourself a wife or you'll be lonely. Once I was 11 years old.
Okay, put some stank on.
I always had that dream, like my daddy before me. So I started writing songs, I started writing stories. Something about the glory just always seemed to bore me. Cause only those I really love will ever really know me.
Soon I'll be 60 years old, my daddy got 61. Remember life and then your life becomes a better one. I made a man so happy when I wrote a letter once. I hope my children come and listen once or twice a month.
Soon I'll be 60 years old. That it's all a dream.
open up your heart. When you love someone, you may go. If you love someone and you're not afraid to lose them, you probably not love someone like I do. You probably not love someone like I do.
When you say the way I make you feel, everything becomes so real. Yeah, don't be scared, no, don't be scared that it's all a dream. Oh. And you still look perfect as days go by. Even the worst ones, you make me smile. Stop the world if it gave us time. When you love someone, you open up your heart. When you love someone, you may grow. If you love someone and you're not afraid to lose them, you probably never love someone like I do. Love someone like I do.
What's up, YouTube? Darin Ong.
And my name is Kimo Goyman Gumatay. Sa mauban.
Maraming salamat. Thank you so much for watching our cover. Sana nag-enjoy kayo. And please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channels. My name is Darin Ong Official.
My name is Kimo Gumatay. And also follow my social media, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. At ako, YouTube channel ko, Samang Ubat, and follow nyo rin ako sa Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, at Samang Ubat.
Salamat!
Thank you!
Yo, I had to watch that. I couldn't not watch that, because I'm just shocked how they don't sound nothing like how they sing. Goodness gracious, they don't sound anything like how they sing. That's crazy to me. Anyway, that was really, really nice. That was really, really nice. Where do I start? Let's start with the friends, okay? Sam had a very different tone in the beginning, to me, but he sounded really, really good. And then his tone at the beginning didn't match the other times he sang. They all sounded more regular. His tone sounded more unique in the beginning, but in the end, it was, I guess maybe I got used to his voice pop, perhaps, or he was just singing in a different style. I don't know. But he had a really, really nice voice. And then, the skinny one, I can't remember, I think Kinko? Kinky? I forgot what he said his name was, but it was something long. He sang so hard. He was hitting his words so strong. He's really had a lot of feeling going on. I really liked his voice. I liked the passion that he put into it as well. I think he did like one of them. He did like a little hum moment or something like that. And it was great. And they both were good singers. But then when Daryl came on, his tone is just ridiculous. Like, his tone is just, it was just so far. I don't want to downplay his friends to him, but his tone just seems so superior to theirs. And despite them being really good singers, his tone was just on a different level, if that makes any sense. And then he started adding in the runs. He did some, as usual, he did some really, really crazy runs. He changed up the melody, because even though Lucas Graham, the lead singer Lucas Graham does have a nice, a really unique voice and a nice voice, and he can sing. They added some stuff that is not in the songs, and when they were singing together, so I think there was at one point these two were singing together, and then maybe it was these two that were singing together. Their voices sounded so good together, so good. Oh, I was missing the Boudicale. I was missing a Bugoy. I was missing Sam or Michael. Where did I get Sam from? Is it? It's not Sam, is it? It's Michael. Oh, he goes by Cal. Sam. Silly Brian. But I was missing them. Maybe not so. Maybe not necessarily with these guys, but I was missing them with Daryl. But maybe they could have been a super group. You know? And does Daryl Ong only roll people that can sing? Like, does he not have friends that can't sing? Because everybody that he rolled with can sing. I find that crazy. It seems like my Philippines friends. Can everybody just sing? Like, if you go outside, like, does the mailman, can the mailman sing? Can the person that work at the grocery with in the market, can she sing? Can he sing? Can the daycare worker sing? Can the baby sing? Like, does everybody sound so damn good? Because he hasn't brought a friend on to the show that can't sing. Anyway, it's a good thing, but man, I'm like, can somebody just be aight? Make me feel better about myself. Can somebody just be aight? No, I'm really happy that everyone can sing. It's a gift. It's a truly great gift. And the Philippines must be a very, very blessed place to have that many gifted singers. Because it is a gift bestowed upon God. So, thank you guys so much for recommending this to me. I'm sorry it took so long, but I'm so happy to watch it. Which one did you guys prefer more? Did you prefer Love Someone or did you prefer 7 Years? I don't know. I'm going to let y'all answer. I'm going to go back and watch. I might comment. I don't know. As far as like songs, I prefer 7 Years. But as far as covers, I think I might have liked Love Someone better. I don't know, though. I have to listen to it one more time. But I think I prefer the cover of Love Someone. Anyway, thank you guys so much for being here. If you need someone to love, love on me, okay? And don't take 7 years to do it. You can do it right now. Hit the subscribe button. Let's be friends, okay? Comment. Let me know that you were here. And also, just like the video. Hopefully, the next time you guys see me, I'll be better. But I don't think I will be just yet because it'll take a little bit more time. But until then, I'll be in the next video. So go there. That's where I'll be. I love you guys. Peace.